We now have on the line PMP spokesperson, Colonel Jean Fajardo. Colonel?
Good afternoon, Tehran.
Good afternoon. Now, today's the deadline. 10 police officers have not tendered their courtesy resignations. Can you tell us first what's the breakdown of that? How many generals, how many colonels?
Yes, sir, Ron, as of 2 p.m. today, there are 943 out of 950 third-level officers of the PNP already submitted their courtesy resignation. That translates to 99.26%. There are 138 out of the 943 generals, and 804 are colonels, and one the inspector generals of the Internal Affairs Service.
For those who have not resigned, I'm seeing now it's, did you say 943 out of 950?
That is correct, sir.
So that leaves seven police officers who did not submit the courtesy resignations. How many generals and how many colonels did not send the resignation?
Out of the seven senior officers who have yet to submit their courtesy resignation, three are generals and four are police colonels.
Are they still being convinced to resign this last day, this deadline for the submission of resignations?
Well, hopefully, before the day ends, they will at least decide and opt to submit their courtesy resignation. And that is the hope of our PNP chief.
Colonel, what's their reason for not sending in their resignations?
The seven senior officers who opted not to submit yet their courtesy resignation are all retirable within the coming days, if not months, sir.
Okay, now.
And that is basically the reason why they opted not to submit, since the explanation given to us that once you submit your courtesy resignation and the same will be accepted by the president, it will be considered as your retirement. And hence, the seven senior officers just opted to wait for their mandatory retirement from the PNP service in the coming days, if not weeks.
Okay, so if their resignations are accepted by the president, just to clarify, did you say that their retirement is going to be an automatic retirement for them instead of being resigned?
That is that is the explanation given to us, Sir Ron, that all senior officers who will be tendering their resignation, that includes the 943 who earlier submitted their courtesy resignation, and once our courtesy resignation will be accepted by the appointing authority, meaning the president, it will be considered as our retirement. And that is basically the reason given by the seven senior officers who opted not to submit their resignation. Mm-hmm. Since our courtesy resignation will be considered as our retirement, hence they just opt to wait for the retirement in the coming days, if not weeks, or so on.
Okay. Now, the investigation comes next after the deadline. We've only heard of Mayor Benjamin Magalong being a part of this five-man board. When will this panel be completed?
We expect that after today, if not tomorrow, in the coming days to come, there will be an official announcement by our SILG, Attorney Benjar Abalos, of the five-man committee that will be conducting the assessment evaluation of those senior officers who opted to submit their courtesy resignation.
Now, we've heard that former PNP chiefs were invited or were tapped to be part of this panel. Can you give us that teaser?
I understand that some of the recommended personalities by the PNP hierarchy, they submitted at least 22 names to SILG, and some of them were retired PNP generals.
Okay. Now, when will the investigation start? After the five-man board is completed, when will the investigation start? But more importantly, how long will the evaluation take place?
Well, we are expecting that as soon as the five-man committee will be named in the coming days, they will immediately convene and lay down all the parameters and procedures that will be undertaken by the five-man committee. And as per announcement of our SILG, it will at least take 2 to 3 months before the committee will finalize their assessment, and results of their assessment will be submitted to NAPOLCOM, and the NAPOLCOM will review the same prior to submitting it to our president.
So the evaluation may take a couple of months, 2 to 3 months, but it could go longer with that because it has to go through the president. Now, the acceptance of the resignations of these police officers will have to go through that whole process of how many months? But don't these resignations put everything up in the air with police officials not sure what's going to happen to them while the evaluation is taking place? And they could be distracted by this whole situation. Can the PNP assure that it can still fully and effectively function while the evaluation is ongoing?
That is the assurance given to us, Sir Ron, by the PNP leadership, that while the process is still ongoing, there will be no relief on our respective position, so that so as not to hamper the delivery of security services. And for those resignation that will be accepted, they will be allowed to retire with their benefits intact, unless of course corresponding criminal cases will be filed against them. Then their retirement benefits will be held in abeyance, mm-hmm. Pending the resolution of the possible criminal case that will be filed against those who will be found liable for involvement in illegal drug activities.
Finally, Colonel Jean, what's the PNP's expectations after the evaluation is completed? What kind of police force are you seeing after this evaluation?
Well, the senior officer, and not only the senior officer, but the PNP organization expect that after the culmination of this process, the PNP will be in a better position. Our subordinates will have high regards to their senior officer, because now no less than the chief PNP and the other senior officer opted to set aside their personal interests for the betterment of the PNP organization as a whole.
Police Colonel Jean Fajardo, the spokesperson of the PNP. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.